Christmas in the Mushroom Kingdom. The toads were gleefully happy. The holiday ham was delicious, and the fruitcake was crappy. Yes, the Mushroom Kingdom loved Christmas quite a lot. But Waluigi, who lived just south of the Mushroom Kingdom, did not. Some say it was because his mustache didn't curl just right. Others say it was because he couldn't be in Smash Bros. To fight. But I think the most likely reason of all was that his heart was two sizes too small. But whatever the reason, his heart or his stash, he always hated the kingdom's Christmas bash.
I hate those kids with their songs and their toys.
But the thing I hate most of all is all the noise!
Waluigi sat with a deep frown and said,
"I'm bugged." And thumbs down.
Waluigi, are you monologuing again? Don't lie.
Yeah.
How was he waiting?
Bullseye. I've been putting up with this for 18 years now. I must put an end to it. But how?
Then Waluigi had an idea. An awful idea. A wonderful, awful idea. Waluigi said to himself with a laugh in his throat,
"I'll make a Santa Claus hat and coat."
"You're a mean one, Waluigi. You've a rotten purple core. You kick out Christmas carolers that come singing at your door, Waluigi. You're the kind of guy that would rob a candy store." So Waluigi had finished his suit.
"Wait, stop. I have to take a poop."
Why was that scene even in the original? I mean...
"Wario, being not so bright, will you guide my sleigh tonight?"
"There's no way I'm hauling that trash. That is, unless you give me some cash."
Mush, I say. Let's get going.
Shouldn't we wait until it stops snowing?
"Let's go, Wario, then I'll leave you be."
Okay, fine. You're dead to me.
Wario, stop stalling!
"I'm not stalling. Waluigi, we're falling!"
"Yes, we're moving! Now, Wario, let's get grooving!"
Through the snow, they went in their box, moving as fast as Melee Fox.
Hi-ya!
They arrived at the first house, Wario crying for his mama. Waluigi, bag in hand, said,
"Time to end this drama."
"You're repulsive, Waluigi. You've got wigglers in your smile. You have all the love and splendor of Mr. Trump's Twitter profile, Waluigi. Given a choice between the two of you, I'd take Trump's Twitter profile." Waluigi spun around to see Cindy Lou Toad wearing a dress that was recently sewed.
Santa!
"What?
Why are you stealing our presents while we're in bed?"
Waluigi quickly grabbed a sledgehammer and hit her in the head. "You're a foul one, Waluigi. You're as useless as a toad. Your heart is full of black and mold. You're nasty a la mode, Waluigi. I have three words to say to you, and they are as follows, and I quote, hit the road."
"All right, that's all of them. Now let's head back."
Waluigi said to Wario, holding a sack,
Mush, come on, let's go."
Okay, I'm just one Wario."
Wario started up the mountain lickety-split. They rode their load to the tip-top to dump it.
"Yes, let's go. We can't miss the show."
"I can't wait to watch them weep and cry." "Oh yeah, Wario, you can leave now. Goodbye."
"Actually, I kind of want to watch this. Take that, Toad's boo hiss."
Waluigi heard a sound out beyond the snow. It started low, then began to grow.
"Oh, he's falling down!"
Christmas come this way.
This sound wasn't sad, why, this sound was glad.
I stole their games, their toys, their knickknacks, and now they're singing? How are they bounced back?
Waluigi then thought, maybe Christmas didn't come from the store. Maybe it was something much more.
What? The sled is falling.
The toads are bawling.
Get up here.
What happened next in the kingdom, they say, is that Waluigi's small heart grew 3 sizes that day.
What's going on?
Then the true meaning of Christmas came through, and he gained the strength of 10 Waluigis, plus 2.
Wario, let's go back to the village, so we can return these gifts we've pillaged.
Okay.
Girls and boys, everyone, I got your toys!
As Waluigi sat down for Christmas dinner, he thought to himself,
man, I'm a winner. I would like to thank you all for this splendid time. Can we eat now? It sucks to speak in rhyme.
That day, Waluigi learned that Christmas isn't about presents under the tree, but about love and compassion for friends and family.